sign everyone up and welcome back to another edition of This Week in the XFL. I'm your host, as always, the referee representing XFL Newsroom. Ooh, the number one source in XFL news. It's a new year, it's a new look, and sign you up. And as you can tell right now, we're upgrading the studio facilities, and hopefully it works out as we expected. But we have a lot of huge news to talk about this week. But before we get started, we wanted to announce another giveaway. Now, this one's going to be a little bit shorter. So last Sunday, we did our This Year in the XFL special. And again, thanks to Tron Hawkins of This Is the XFL podcast, Jay Dash of XFL Newsroom Unhinged, and the XFL delivery guy for coming through. But we're doing another live stream February 7th, the day before the league officially kicks off. And as you know, that's right around the corner. Well, we're gonna give away two more tickets, and the rules are the same. All you gotta do is like, comment, subscribe, and here's the important part. You gotta click the link down in the description for the Discord. Get up to at least a rookie status. It's about 50 or 60 posts. But the good news is you'll be able to hang out with a bunch of other like-minded XFL fans, just like you and me. So hey, let's not waste any more time. We have a huge news to talk about this week. We're gonna start off a little bit slow. We're gonna talk about the latest transactions, and we just have a few, but the only team here is in Dallas, so it looks like safety Jalen Harvey has been waived, but they did pick up three more players. Wide receiver James Quick, linebacker Kristen Kuntz, and offensive tackle Derek Pooney. So it's again, mini camps have wrapped up. Training camps are coming this weekend. We'll talk about that later in the episode here. But we're seeing these teams start to gel, and this is part of the process. So we're gonna see some more of these players leave. We're gonna probably see some more players come onto these groups. There was some rumors that the league was gonna hold a supplemental draft on January 2nd. At least at the time of the recording, we haven't heard anything about that yet. But again, those were kind of rumors, and also some hearing some words from, you know, players trying to get into that draft. And this is really just according to what their agents had to say. But again, we're getting close. We're really right around the corner. I don't think I never really thought it would be here. And here we are, you know, like again, about a month from now, we're going to be talking about the games. Like I said, February 7th, Friday, probably around 8 p.m. Eastern. Again, we're going to do another live stream, another live panel show. And if you didn't check out our This Year in the XFL special, we'll have a link down in the description. You should check it out just to see what we thought were the best moments of 2019, as well as the fans. We reveal the fan poll, over 1,000 entries. So go check it out. See who best team, best jersey, things like that are. So those are just some transactions. You know, as we mentioned, kickoff is right around the corner. There's still a couple things that people are wondering about, right? The rule book, which again, we'll talk about a little bit later here. Not social media, but fantasy football, things of that nature. But one thing that fans have been asking for and wondering about is football cards. Now, we saw the Alliance of American Football, they put out a trading card set with Tops. Well, the good news is if you like those Topps cards, it looks like they're moving on and they're going to be working with the XFL as well. So they're going to be putting out a 200 card set that's going to be released around March. And within the cards, you're going to have players, head coaches, things like that. And it is very similar to the AAF set, right, as far as the structure. There's a lot of parallels and similarities. Really, the major differences are the colors and the team logos, things like that. A lot of the players will actually be the same in all reality here. So 1 in 6 packs will contain a Stars of the XFL card, so kind of like a special card. And within each box, you're guaranteed at least 3 autographs. So I'm excited. I'm looking forward to collecting the full set. Let us know down in the description, what are some cards that you're trying to get? What are those players or even maybe those head coaches that you're looking to add in your collection? Me personally, I want them all. But hey, I'll take a Connor Cook, I'll take a PJ Walker, I'll take a June Jones, I'll take all of the Roughnecks. Sign me up there. But hey, trading cards, it's getting more real by the day. Like I said, we really only have that fantasy football thing kind of open in the air on what's left, but they have confirmed that it's coming, right? So we know the trading cards now are coming in March. We have fantasy football coming. We have the rule book coming. We have training camps coming. And most importantly, February 8th, we have the XFL coming, hitting the field. Finally, like I said, it's starting to get more and more real every day. So we're moving on to maybe not the greatest news, but we have to talk about it because we are the XFL newsroom. Well, it looks like Vince McMahon is being sued by a WWE shareholder, so somebody that owns stock in the WWE. I'll preface this before we get into the news. I would not be too concerned with this. It's really more of an exploratory thing, trying to figure out what that relationship is between the WWE and the XFL. And a lot of it really comes down to looking at, you know, what is that relationship? Is there money going back and forth? Are they valuing things the right way? Are they using resources from the WWE that they shouldn't be? But in all reality, the shareholder is a minor shareholder. Not that that's, you know, any way to disregard him. But these lawsuits do kind of come and go in these types of situations. But according to Forbes Law, the suit suggests that the company's board members may have failed to conduct appropriate oversight to ensure McMahon didn't engage in transactions that conflict with WWE's interests. So again, kind of talking about using those resources or moving money. But basically, the lawsuit comes down to four different things, trying to figure out these four different things. Did Alpha Entertainment, so the XFL's parent company, which is wholly owned by Vince McMahon, pay fair market value for the WWE for the intellectual properties of the XFL? So the name, the logo, things like that, which including giving a WWE a percentage of that, right? Next part is Alpha paying WWE fair market value for the support services that the WWE is providing? So like video things. And quite honestly, we're getting to the point where we're not going to see a lot of the help from the WWE, but in those building stages, there was some crossover. Was the XFL revival announced before the deal was completed, right? So did they know? Was there some market value money going around that shouldn't have been? And so really, that's what it's coming down to. And like I said at the beginning of this, I wouldn't pay it too much concern. These things kind of happen, especially with money. This is a minor shareholder, but we'll keep you in the loop as we learn more. We post on all good or bad. We are the XFL Newsroom, which you should be checking out daily for all the latest news. So earlier in this episode, we had mentioned that the rule book was coming soon, and Oliver Luck had stated a few weeks ago that it was coming after the holidays. Well, here we are, we're after the holidays, but the good news is it sounds like we have an official release date, January 7th, Tuesday, January 7th, we're getting that rule book, at least according to sources here. And that's awesome, right? So the mini camps have wrapped up. We have the training camps wrapping up or kicking off the 4th. Maybe having a supplemental draft in there. We don't know, at least at the time of the recording, but we have that official rule book. It will be released and we will be able to, it's going to be utilized during these training camps. Absolutely. So again, all 8 teams are coming to the Houston area. They all have their own specific locations. And I think it's going to be great for the people that live in Houston, because in all reality, this is your first chance to see all of the XFL teams on the field, right? So we know some of the rules they're testing, right? But nothing has been officially solidified yet. So that's what's going to be important to see what's in this rule book. But some of the things we know they're testing that seem like they're going to be a part of the game is that faster game clock. So 25-second game clock, 1 foot inbound, so similar to college. Again, a lot of these are designed to keep that game going. You know, maybe not have to rely on the refs to review so many things if it doesn't really pertain to the rules. We saw the differences in the kickoffs, extra points. So the 1, 2, and 3 point extra points there, right? You don't have an extra kick. You don't have an extra point kick, but you have 3 different plays from the 1, 2, and 10 yard line here. Or sorry, the 2, 5, and 10 yard line, excuse me, for the 1, 2, and 3. Multiple forward passes, so not just limited to one. And again, it's gonna be difficult, but I guarantee we'll see it somewhere down the line. And to me, the most exciting one is that overtime where you have both offense and defense on each side of the field taking turns in basically best out of 5. So I'm excited to see these rules come out. So as we mentioned, the rule book's coming out just in time for the training camp. Well, it's officially being released shortly after the training camp kicks off this weekend, January 4th, here in Houston. All 8 teams are traveling out here. They all have their unique location where they can practice. And we've heard there's going to be scrimmages. And the good news is people were wondering, are fans going to be able to attend these events? And I'm sure there's going to be more announcements in the future, but we have the first official announcement. So January 11th, the Houston Roughnecks have opened up their training camp where they're practicing with the Tampa Bay Vipers. So again, like we mentioned, this is your first chance to see two XFL teams on the field at the same time. We saw it before with the mini camps where you could see, you know, that one team on the field in those practice jerseys, but this is really the fans' first opportunity to see two teams on the field at the same time. I know I'll be there, I'm excited. Being that all eight teams are in town, I wouldn't doubt if there's some surprises there. Maybe we'll hear from the commish himself, Oliver Luck. This is just speculation, I don't know if that's going to happen. But I do know that every time the XFL holds some type of fan engagement event, there's something special there. Overall, this is it. We're right around the corner. We're a month away. We're bringing on new contributors to the site. We're expanding new content. We're about to talk about all sorts of new things. We're gonna have power rankings and all sorts of good stuff, weekly previews and picks. And this week in the XFL is about to get a lot more interesting. Like I said, we're about a month away, about four episodes away from when we're finally going to be seeing the action on the field. And look forward, you know, like I said, we're going to be trying to give you the best coverage. But if you're interested in contributing to the site, head over to xflnewsroom.com, click the Join Us button up in the navigation, fill out the form because we want to hear from you. We have a bunch of great folks. We have some people over in DC. We have some in Dallas. We have some all over the map, but we can never have enough. We have a couple new podcasts joining the site as well, so look forward to that as well. Like I said, we're just getting excited here. Everything's just getting a little bit more real. Every day, you know, every day we're one day closer, right? We're less than 50 days, less than 40 days from the XFL kickoff, and I can't believe I thought I'd be saying those words a year ago, but here we are. Like I said, we have a new studio set up. I don't know, this is just recording now, so hopefully it works out as good as I hope it does. But I guarantee it'll get better every week. We always look forward to your comments, your questions, your concerns, so make sure you let us know down below. And again, thanks for making us the number one subscribed XFL news outlet on the internet. We're looking forward to bringing you the best coverage and holding that crown for a long time to come and covering XFL 2020 and beyond. But hey, that's really about it for this week. Next week, we'll be going over all the rules. We'll have a whole bunch of different things to talk about, I'm sure, with the training camps. But hey, before we let you go, if you didn't know, we're also on Facebook and Twitter. So make sure you give us a follow at XFL Newsroom for all the latest news. And since we're on YouTube, make sure you drop a like, comment, subscribe, and click the bell to see when we're dropping new videos. Some are going to be live and some are going to be pre-recorded just like this one. So until next time, ooh, sign you up.